Welcome back to ARK Survival Evolved. I'm KnowItAllDM. Today, I am going to do something a little bit different than normal. Apart from starting on Seatooth here. First, I'm going to show you what I've done with the ships and stuff that I have crafted up in the previous episodes. First of all, it's KnowItAllDM's Oceanic Town. So, I've got the courtyard that I built up in the first episode, right here. And I've got the sea cabin and the sea smithy, or smithy ship, that I built before starting the episodes, attached to the courtyard, right here. And other buildings that I have planned are going to go there and right here and possibly another one like right here, but I don't think I want to block the ramp that I've got coming up to the smithy ship, so I might put a smaller one right here, or I could extend this out to a dock to the mazventure galley and have that where we pull the mazventure galley every time we come back from an adventure. Speaking of which, today I plan on setting up the mazventure galley for our first mazventure. To do that, I'm going to need to stock it up with food and stuff, get the interior of it all set up for a mazventure. I'm probably going to have some supplies that I put down here in the cargo hold. I'm going to stock up the cooking pot and all of the fireplaces with wood. I'm going to fill up the two preserving bins here with food and spark powder and the like. Don't know if I'll put anything in here right now, but... And then I want to set up the interior in here with stuff so that if I have to respawn, I can quickly re-equip and continue on. And joining us for the journey will be Jack. That's right. Jack the monkey. So Jack will be joining us on this mazventure. And I haven't quite decided what I want to put up here. This would be where the steering column would go on. Okay. Looks like we're having some PvP going on. This would be where the steering column on a normal ship would be. But since this is based off a raft, that's under the deck. So I don't know what I want to put up here. And I'm sliding. Yeah, if you didn't know, railings cause you to slide until you fall off. So, yeah, that's a thing. But I'm going to go ahead and take the mazventure galley, bring it a little closer to shore, and we will start stocking it up, and I'll be back. And we're back. And so I've brought the mazventure galley onto a nearby shore. Right there's the obelisk, and our base is right out that way. I brought it over here, and Seatooth here decided to tag along. So I'm going to utilize him, let him hang out, and hold some stuff for me while Jack and I come around and gather some resources. Now, the first thing I'm going to want to do right here is build a little dock so I can get up onto the mazventure galley. To do that, I will go around gathering some resources, which are way over there and over there, wood and the like. The reason I parked the mazventure galley so far away is because I don't want to build the dock where it'll stop trees and stuff from respawning. And right over here, there is a drop that lands right here. So I don't want to park nearby here and build a dock that will block that as well. So, I'm going to go gather up some resources and build that dock, and I'll be back. And we're back with a dodo that is stranded in the water. So Jack and I were just looking around gathering resources, and I saw this dodo just out here on the rock, staring at whoever's base that is. And a pillar of light. A pillar of light that only contains a medium crop plot blueprint. That's right. The most valued item in the game, the medium crop plot blueprint. I think I'll leave it there for somebody else lucky enough to stumble across it. But for now, we will leave this female dodo. Level 8. In peace. And continue gathering wood. I'll be back. And we've got the dock built. So it's a simple little dock where you can just come down here and get up here. Getting back is a little glitchy, but just take a little bit slow. You'll get there. And yeah, so we've got the dock built. Now it's time to start supplying up the Mazventure galley. First, I think I'm going to start by filling up the fireplaces and the cooking pot with wood. And then I am going to probably I might start cooking up some meat to fill the preserving bins, and then I will make spark powder so that the meat doesn't die. I will probably go diving in a little bit down this way and take my shark down, take what's his name, Seatooth down, and see if I can get some oil, and if I can get some oil, then I will be able to make more jerky. Hooray for jerky. But once I get the wood gathered up and filling those up, I will take you on a little hunting expedition. Sounds fun, huh? Alright, we'll be back. Alright, I've crafted up almost 200 plus arrows. In fact, I've cracked up more than 200 arrows, 272. So we are going to start killing! First thing I think I want to start killing is our friend, the Rock Dodo. Alright! And of course, I don't kill things just for fun. I use every bit of every animal that I kill. Every bit that I can. So let's continue on and just get ourselves a bunch of meat. Now, okay, this is not good. Not good. I think I shot the wrong trike. Oh no. And where did Seatooth go? Okay, the trikes have stopped following. Seatooth has wandered off. Seatooth. So I've been hunting for a while. My crossbow is about to break. So let's get Seatooth and bring him back. And hey, look, Seatooth has some meat on him. Huh. I guess I didn't need to kill all those defenseless animals. Well, that's my bad. All right, so we're back. And we've got campfires burning, cooking up some meat. So the next thing I need to do is get some spark powder started for these preserving bins. Now, for spark powder, I'm not going to need this crossbow and all this stuff, because rocks don't fight back. So I'm just going to put all this stuff in here. Actually, I'm going to need these, because that trike that was attacking me actually came back and attacked the Mazventure galley as I was trying to get into here to cook up some meat. So I'm going to need to repair that, but I can drop all that weight. I did get a little bit of oil while I was out hunting, so let's go ahead and just put that right up in there. And let's go out and gather up some stone and flint and get our spark powder. So one thing I didn't take into account is that there's not a lot of stone and flint right around the boat, so I'm having to walk all the way down there and then all the way back for just a little bit of stone and flint. So I think I'm going to enlist the help of my beaver. Now, the beaver's still back over at the shipyard, so I'm going to have to quick travel over there and bring her back. So to do that, whoa, there was some lag. I'm going to put everything in here. I did just get a blue drop, and I got those two out of it. And put these in there, and that in there. All right. And Jack. Jack. What happened to Jack? He's no longer on my shoulder. Jack, where did you go? Jack seems to have fallen off of my shoulder somewhere. So not only am I going to have to go get my beaver, I'm also going to have to find Jack. Jack the monkey, where did you go? Well, I'm going to have to look for Jack, but I will do that with my beaver. So let's just quick travel on over to KnowItAllDM's dry dock. Hello, Norma. You have a lot of stuff. You're going to have to leave some of that here. Wait. What happened to Norma's saddle? It looks like somebody has taken Norma's saddle. Can you keep up? Oh yeah, you can keep up real well. Alright. Well, I'm going to get Norma back to the boat. I might stop off by the raft base and drop off some of that metal. And I'll be back. And I'm back. And so I got Norma. She's right outside the boat. And I came up here. Got all the meat. And let's take the little bit of spark powder that we had crafted up here. And go ahead and throw it in here. Get my meat on storing. So I logged out for a bit, and hoping that when I logged back in, the saddle would be back, just a glitch that occasionally happens, or at least used to, but unfortunately it seems that saddle is gone. So I went ahead and learned the engram for the Castoroides saddle, and before the end of the episode, I hope to craft up a saddle for Norma. And it appears that some people are still spelunking in one of the caves. So, let's go on and take Norma out and fill her up with rocks and flint. And when I get a lot of spark powder and the like. And hey, look, I found Jack! Yay! Jack, don't ever leave again! And yeah, once I get rocks and stones like that, I'll be back. Alright, and we're back. And I've got a lot of flint and stone in each of these mortar and pestles. So let's go ahead. 2, 4, 6, 800 there. And 2, 4, 6, 700 there. Why is it only 700 here? Was it 700 here? Should have been 8 and 8. Oh, because there was spark powder there. No, wait. No? Okay, well, I don't know. I don't know. Why was that only 700? I don't know. That was confusing me. Anyway, so I'm going to let those start crafting up. And I figured out what I'm going to do with this box over here. I'm going to keep spark powder in it. Sorry, my voice cracked there a little bit. I'm going to keep spark powder in it. So, I've got Norma up here with still a lot of stone and stuff. While I was out, I found a couple more blueprints and some more stuff that I want to go ahead and put in the storage chests in here so I can take them back to the base. Blueprints in here. And I found a paintbrush blueprint. So I think I am going to end up painting the boat. I crafted up a paintbrush already. And at least I'm going to paint the outside of the boat. The inside, probably not. But the outside of the boat is definitely going to be painted. So now let's, now that I've got my beaver here, I am actually going to have put it on wander for a bit and let it get some wood. I'm going to need to empty out its inventory before it'll actually collect wood, because they only collect up to half their inventory so that they don't, get overburdened. So I'm going to have to do something about that. So yeah, I've got this chest full of spark powder here, plus I'm gonna have this full and that full. So now I've got to get enough wood and stuff to cook up enough meat to make sure that my preserving bins are full. So Norma, come back over to here. And stop there. And come straight off of here. Don't run around. Straight here. Straight over here, Norma. I know you can do it. I've seen you do it before. Multiple times. Come on, Norma. Nope. This way. There you go. All right. So I'm going to have her sit around on wander, and I'm going to cook up a bunch more meat. And once I get all that meat cooked up and everything, I'll be back. And we're back. And I've cooked up enough meat that I could fill this entire preserving bin and this entire preserving bin. And this one has already started to make jerky. So I've got a little excess meat cooking up that I will end up putting in my preserving bins back at the raft base when I get back there. And then I will start working on outfitting more stuff in here. As I was gathering stuff, what I got from drops, I got enough stuff that I can set up in just about any small campsite you can think about, fire campfires, sleeping bags, storage boxes, anything that I wanted. So that's not going to be a problem. I also got... where is it? Over here. All these blueprints, which you've seen most of. Let me consolidate this into here with that one. And I got a lot of wood and a lot of meat and I got a lot of oil. Not more than, you know, I got a bit of oil. And I won't say a lot. I did say a lot. I didn't mean a lot. But once I get all this meat cooked up and get all this meat cooked up, I will head back to the raft base. And can I get out of my door, please? And I will start working on something else to get prepared for tomorrow's adventure. And I think you'll like what that is. So I'll be back. And I'm back. So after the last cut, the server went down for a automatic restart and maintenance. But it's back up now, and I've gathered some materials to continue on preparing for tomorrow's adventure. So what I wanted to prepare up was this. I've got enough metal and resources in my smithy that I can build a pistol, long neck rifle, and a shotgun. I also have enough that I can build scope to go on the rifle and a sword. I also would want to get hide and fiber. I've got hide and fiber. Okay. A spyglass. And then I can just put all this stuff back in there. So, now I've got all the weapons that I wanted to take along with me. Next, I just need to craft the ammo for them, which is going to require gunpowder. Now, to make gunpowder, I need a lot of charcoal and spark powder. Now, earlier, I crafted up a whole bunch of spark powder, and in here, I have been saving up charcoal. I can't move with all that. So let me put all these in here for now. And that's still too much. Let's put... how about that? Can I move now? All right, I can move. And now it's a 1-to-1 ratio, so that's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and 6. So, now we've got a lot of gunpowder being made. And once it's all crafted up, I can make ammunition for my guns. And we're done! We have gunpowder! And more gunpowder! And a little bit of spark powder. So, let's go throw this into the smithy and see what kind of ammos we can create. What I'm going to need simple bullets to make shotgun ammo. And to make rifle ammo, I just need gunpowder and metal ingots, and gunpowder and metal ingots for the simple bullets. So, I'm going to go ahead and craft up 200 simple bullets. And then once I get enough that I can make 50 shotgun shells, I will make 50 shotgun shells. That should be 150 simple bullets, leaving me with 50 shotgun shells and 50 simple bullets. I will probably end up crafting more simple bullets. I'll get the 50 shotgun shells and 50 simple bullets, then figure out how many rifle ammo I want to make. And while those are crafting up, I'm going to go retrieve my firearms. Not here. There. Oh, and I've got more charcoal. I can make more gunpowder. Just so that it does it faster. I'm going to go ahead and put more charcoal in each of these. And how many of each do we have? I'm four short on the... No, I've got way too many simple bullets. Okay, that's... Take all that, combine that. All right, I've got extra simple bullets. That's fine. Let's see what kind of ammo I can make with this. I can make 42 of those. So, I'm going to want to make 20 of that. 4 more of that. I didn't mean to make that many. Stop it. Okay. Take these. There. Perfect. All right. Anyway. Yeah. So, I've got my weapons, and, let's just go ahead and see what it would take to make a smithy, so I can throw one down on the ship. Craftable structures, crafting, smithy. Finding it, stone, wooden hide. So let's take wood, hide, stone, more stone, mega smithy. And then I can put all this back. And now I've got a lot of oil in here. I don't need the oil in there, I don't think. Actually, I want to make grenades, so I do need oil. I can make 2 grenades. What is the limiting factor? Stone. Stone is the limiting factor on these grenades. So I'm going to go get more stone and make grenades. Now, do I have any stone just lying around here somewhere? I don't think so. I might have some in here. Nope. Did I have any anywhere else? I don't think so. So I'm going to have to go gather some more stone and make grenades. I think I will actually end up doing that. On the pirate boat. On the mazventure galley during our adventure. I'll go ahead and craft up the 2 we got here. And then where should I set up this smithy? I think down here would actually be the most beneficial place to set it up. So let's see, if I go ahead and just set it up right here in the corner over here. Come on. Right there. All right. Let's go ahead and put this on the long neck rifle. All right, so I've got the smithy here where I can fix up my weapons and such. I'm not going to have a refining forge, so I'm going to have to take the metal with me. But let's go ahead and see what we can do about getting the stuff moved over from that smithy to this smithy. And Seatooth, you are going to assist me. And Seatooth has a level! More health! I'm going to try to get Seatooth up to about 10,000 health and then pump nothing else but melee damage, because I'm trying to get Seatooth... Why is my under door in the smithy opened? Did I leave that open? I think I left that open last time I was here. Okay. I never put a ladder here. Why did I never put a ladder here? I am a doofus. Okay, I'm going to get the stuff transferred over, and I will be back. All right, and we're back. And I've filled up the smithy with everything from the other smithy, and I've got myself some weaponry to begin our adventure with the pirate sword, the shotgun for close-range engagements, the pistol for charging enemies or other things that I need to shoot a bit further than a shotgun. And for long range engagements, I've got my long neck rifle with scope. So, now that I've got all those, we are going on an adventure. In the next episode, I will be taking the Mazventure galley out, sailing the high seas, and looking for treasure. And other things that may happen along the way. So, if you liked the episode, go ahead and hit that thumbs up button. And if you want to see more ARK Survival Evolved, don't forget to subscribe. I'm KnowItAllDM, and y'all have a good day now.